Hey everybody, welcome back. For those of you who are new here, I'm Marissa and I'm a PADI Master Scuba Diver. Today we're going to be talking about enriched air, what it is, why divers use it, the dangers of it, and the safety aspects of it. There's going to be two parts to this. I'm a big fan of shorter videos. It's just a lot easier for people to digest all of the information. The next episode is going to be more of the science behind Nitrox. I'm going to be talking about partial pressure, which I'll be talking about in today's episode as well, the math, and the dive physics behind enriched air. So stay tuned for that episode as well. Please like, subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss an episode. Separate certification and training is required to dive enriched air. This video does not equate to any certifications and it's for educational purposes only. If you want to become certified with enriched air, please make sure you see a reputable dive shop and instructor. Now let's dive in. Regular air is about 21% oxygen and 79% nitrogen. Enriched air is air that's been modified to have even more oxygen than 21%. If you see EANX or EAN32 in this case, it means it's enriched air with a blend of 32% oxygen in the tank. And 32% oxygen is the example that I'm going to use throughout this video. More oxygen means less nitrogen. So with a tank of 32% oxygen, it has 68% nitrogen. Normally, compared to regular air, that's already 11% less nitrogen that your body is actually absorbing. So the first reason that a lot of divers use enriched air is if they're doing multiple dives in a day. This gas mixture will help reduce the nitrogen buildup within their bloodstream and their body tissues.
You still have to plan the dive safely within limits and always monitor your NDL as well as your depth very frequently.
Less nitrogen also means less time on your surface intervals on the boat in between dives. A second reason a lot of divers use enriched air is they say that they feel less tired with enriched air compared to regular air. And I know for myself, this is definitely the case. I've noticed when I dive regular air, multiple dives, I'm not necessarily tired after the dive, but later on that evening, I'm exhausted. And I've noticed with enriched air, I don't get that tired feeling at the end of the night. It's great for liveaboards, it's great for dive travel, it's great for workers who dive in the water, such as like photographers or instructors who are diving all the time. As far as cost, it's a little bit more to fill your tank with the Nitrox, but honestly, I think it's worth it. We all know oxygen is essential for life. But too much of it under pressure can actually become very dangerous, where oxygen toxicity can occur. As you go deeper, the pressure increases. And this is the term that you have to understand, and it's oxygen partial pressure. So a little bit of review, one ATM or one atmosphere is the air pressure that's surrounding us at sea level. And we don't notice it because we were born into it, so our bodies are already used to it. As you're descending underwater, the total pressure will increase one atmosphere for every 10 meters or 33 feet in salt water. Salt water, 33 feet, fresh water, 34 feet. The difference is because salt water is a lot denser, so the atmosphere is gonna increase a little sooner compared to fresh water. Now, in your tank, you have a blend of gases, oxygen and nitrogen. Oxygen partial pressure refers to the pressure that's exerted only by the oxygen part of that blend, hence the name partial pressure. It is only part of the total pressure within your tank, and the other part would be nitrogen. Mathematically, the oxygen partial pressure is simply the percentage of oxygen in the enriched air multiplied by the pressure at depth in atmospheres. And this is Dalton law. This is something I'm going to get into in the next episode. So the higher the oxygen percentage is in your tank and or the deeper the dive is, the higher the oxygen partial pressure is. Now you might ask yourself, well, how high can the oxygen partial pressure be before it becomes too dangerous to divers? Is there a limit? And the answer is yes, there is a limit. And this is where the dangers of enriched air can come into play if you're not monitoring your depth and your time, as well as your oxygen exposure time. For recreational diving, the maximum oxygen partial pressure is going to be 1.4 ATA. This is the safe working limit to avoid oxygen toxicity. With enriched air, depth is extremely important. With any blend of oxygen in your tank, there's going to be a maximum operating depth, or an MOD, that is associated with that percentage of oxygen. It's the depth that you're allowed to go at with that specific percentage of oxygen that's in your tank. And my friends, if you surpass this, and if you go deeper than your MOD, you are putting yourself extremely high at risk for oxygen toxicity. So let's not do that. None of us want that to happen. Think of it like this. As you go deeper, the ambient pressure increases, right? And this is gonna raise the oxygen partial pressure that you're breathing from your tank, even though the percentage of the oxygen in the tank is still the same. For example, if you're diving enriched air with 32% oxygen, so EAN 32, and you're at 100 feet in depth, the ambient pressure is about 4 ATA. The oxygen itself isn't more concentrated, but it's under more pressure, meaning with each breath, it delivers more oxygen molecules to your body. And really quick, just to calculate the partial pressure with this specific example, I'm gonna go into more on the next episode with the math and the calculations, but all you're gonna do is take the percentage of oxygen, 32%, 0.32, and you're gonna times it by 4, because at 100 feet, you're roughly at 4 atmospheres, and you're gonna get the oxygen partial pressure, which is 1.28 ATA. So at 100 feet, you're experiencing the effect of breathing oxygen at 1.28 ATA, which is kind of like you're breathing 128% of the oxygen exposure that you'd be breathing in with one breath at the surface. In simpler terms, each breath at 100 feet delivers about 4 times the amount of total gas as one breath at the surface. And 32% of that is oxygen. At 100 feet in depth, you're getting more oxygen molecules per breath. This increased pressure and exposure can increase your risk of oxygen toxicity, especially if it's not managed properly. Now, with this oxygen you're breathing in, it's really important to monitor your oxygen exposure limit. Your dive computer will automatically do this for you. It's gonna show you a CNS percentage so you don't exceed those safe oxygen limits. Chart here is kind of just a breakdown of the three things that you have to monitor while you're diving enriched air. Your NDL, as always, to avoid decompression stops. You can use your dive computer or Nitrox tables, but normally a lot of people today use the dive computers. Your CNS percentage to avoid oxygen toxicity. Again, your dive computer tracks this automatically. And then your PO2, which is your oxygen partial pressure. Stay below safe limits. 1.4 ATA is the max. Know your MOD, your maximum operating depth, and check your dive computer frequently. So what I do is, because you know, when you're diving down and you start to see something really cool and you kind of forget about your dive computer and what you're doing, it happens, we're human, we all make mistakes. What I do is set an alert on my dive computer. So if I'm diving 32% oxygen, I will set an alert for 10 feet above my max. So if I'm diving 32, it's gonna be a 111 foot max. I'll set my dive computer for 101 feet. So when it goes off and it vibrates, I feel it, I know, okay, I'm not gonna go down any deeper, or if I do, it's just gonna be a few feet, and then I'm gonna start going up a little bit. But I want everyone to understand, like, this is really important. So if you're a deep diver and you are able to go down the full recreational depth of 130, and you have, for example, 32% oxygen in your tank, the maximum depth you can go at is 111 feet. So even if you're certified to go down deeper, your Nitrox training is going to basically override your other certifications, because you're not gonna go down to 130 feet even though you're certified for it. It will strictly depend on what type of percentage of oxygen you have in your tank. That is gonna tell you the maximum depth that you're allowed to go. So this is a sheet that I received when I got certified in Nitrox. It's gonna tell you on the left-hand side your partial pressure, and you can already see that it's highlighted already for 1.4. The top is going to be the Nitrox blend of oxygen. So you're gonna see 21, which is regular air. 22 to 40 is gonna be the different kinds of percentages of oxygen you can get. Now, the higher percentage of oxygen, the shallower MOD you're gonna have, because you have more oxygen in the tank and it's getting compressed under the pressure being underwater, and oxygen toxicity can occur at a shallower depth, so that MOD is gonna go shallower. So for 32, for example, at the top, you're gonna follow it straight down to the 1.4, and you see 110.7. Now, 111 is the MOD. If you wanna be on the safe side, you can do 110 feet as well. Do what makes you comfortable and set the alert on your dive computer too. I can't stress that enough. That's super important, because you see a sea turtle at 100 feet and you're trying to get it on camera with your GoPro and you forget to look at your depth without an alarm set, it could be really bad. So make sure you have that dive computer set for you. There is a contingency oxygen partial pressure of 1.6. Anything diving beyond 1.6 can result in immediate oxygen toxicity. 1.4 to 1.6 ATA is a margin for error only. This is, again, if you don't set your dive computer to alert you. If you go past 1.4 ATA, this is gonna be something you only use if you accidentally exceed 1.4 ATA. But divers did get oxygen toxicity as well within this range. So please stay above 1.4. And don't set your dive computer to 1.6 ATA, just keep it at 1.4. It breaks my heart to read stories about divers who have passed away at depth with things that were very easily preventable. I understand that other things happen and there are other circumstances, and I wanna say, I think it was Dan, I have to look on the website, on their annual report for diving fatalities, it was about 60 to 80% of dive-relating deaths are involving one human factor or one human error. And that's pretty significant, 60 to 80% if there's things that can be prevented. Make sure you do everything to dive safely and prevent anything from happening down at depth. So here's a chart, just kind of what we talked about, showing the partial pressure and the 1.4 ATA. So at the surface here, you're at one ambient pressure, which is just gonna be before you descend, just the surface pressure that we're used to. The partial pressure is 0.32, which is exactly what you have in your tank. 32% for this example, it's balanced out. When you go down 33 feet for salt water, you're at 2 atmospheres. So now that partial pressure will change to 0.64 or 64%. As you go down another 33 feet, you're at 3 atmospheres. You're at 96.96 ATA. 99 feet, you're at 4 atmospheres. You're at 1.28 ATA. And then the MOD for 32% oxygen is 111 feet. And this is your maximum operating depth because the pressure is 1.4. So you don't want to exceed that. Okay, let's finally get into oxygen toxicity, also known as central nervous system oxygen toxicity. You can have vision changes, including tunnel vision, nausea, ringing in your ears, twitching and muscle spasms, especially in the face, dizziness, and then of course you can have convulsions without any warning. Now convulsions on land by themselves, they're not life-threatening, but being underwater, it's almost guaranteed that you're gonna lose your regulator and you're gonna drown. If someone is convulsing underwater, you'd handle the emergency as you would for any other unresponsive diver. If their regulator is in, hold it there. But if it's not in, don't waste time trying to put it back in their mouth. Immediately surface, get positive buoyancy for you and the diver. Check for breathing. Get them out of the water as fast as possible. Check for a heart rate. Call emergency services. CPR may be needed at this point if there's no breathing. Oxygen is an unforgiving gas, and oxygen toxicity is usually fatal. So being in control underwater is super critical. You want to have good buoyancy, you want to navigate properly. You as a diver, you're responsible for your own safety. A lot of divers will plan their dives and their gas mixes very carefully, just to keep the oxygen partial pressure within safe limits. With managing oxygen exposure, you can do these three things. Set your dive computer up for the maximum oxygen partial pressure of 1.4. Set your dive computer for the specific mix of oxygen that you're using. This is essential so your dive computer can automatically calculate your maximum operating depth, your NDL, and your oxygen exposure. Also, set your dive computer the face of it where you can see this information easily and you're not pressing buttons trying to find what your NDL time is or where you're at, you know, the depth. Make sure it's right on the face of your computer so you can just look down and all the information you need is right there. If you're diving with enriched air, it's a good idea to take these few extra steps. Analyze your tank with an oxygen air analyzer. You always want to double check. Like I said before, people make mistakes and this mistake can cost you your life. So if you have your own air analyzer, when the tank is filled 32%, just test it and make sure that it is at 32%. Label your tank clearly with the mix and the MOD. You can log this information. Most dive shops with Nitrox will have a sheet that you fill out, what percentage you got and what the MOD is. You wanna set your dive computer to the percentage of oxygen that you're diving with. and monitor your depth very closely. Just going a few feet over your MOD can put you in the danger zone. Always have a designated tank for Nitrox. For mine, I have the sticker on it that's wrapped around the tank, and that's the only tank I use for Nitrox. This is really important to remember as well. Nitrox does not let you dive deeper. With a higher percentage of oxygen, it means there's less nitrogen in the tank. And this means that your body is absorbing less nitrogen. So less nitrogen is getting absorbed into your tissues and your bloodstream. As a result of this, it allows you to stay at depth for a little bit longer. I think enriched air is great. It does let you have some more time underwater and it's less nitrogen exposure, but it has to be used in the correct way. Understand partial pressure, know your maximum operating depth, and respect the limits. And remember, enriched air requires a separate certification other than your open water or advanced open water course, whatever you're certified in. And if you want to become certified with enriched air, please make sure you go see a reputable dive shop and instructor that you trust. The next episode is going to be on the physics aspect of enriched air and the calculations behind it. Thank you everyone for watching. If you enjoy this episode and wanted to know more about scuba diving, education in scuba diving, please like, comment, and subscribe, and hit the bell so you don't miss an episode. And we'll see you next time. Bye.